Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, happy time zone, everybody. Sorry for the technical difficulties with that. But good morning, good afternoon, good evening, happy time zone, everybody. This is Road to Dusk. Hope you're all having a good time. I just had a pretty massive hiccup with my computer, which I'm very surprised with, but I'm hoping now things will be a little better. I think I need to open up my VTube studio after my countdown, because that's a big reason on why connection was suddenly lost. But I hope everyone is doing well. I hope you guys are having a really great time. Real quick, before we go too deep into the whole like drawing spiel, I do have some news regarding my streams. So, biggest thing, oh, thank you, Zelda. It takes a cutie to know a cutie. But I have some news for those that have not been keeping up with my have not been keeping up with my Twitter or my Discord. So, at the moment, my financial situation has taken a very, 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 very large dive. And right now, I am having to do double shifts at my tutoring job while I'm still trying to look for a different job. And so right now, that is meaning that I'm going to have to cut my streams in half. I used to be doing Thursday streams, and I was very excited to do Wednesday streams. Both of those were at midnight to 4 a.m., but those cannot happen right now until further notice. Because with the work schedule that I'm going to have coming up, and this stuff with my work, considering how fickle of a situation it is as ESL tutoring, it's not a guarantee that I'm going to get the income that I need. I've literally just opened up my availability for an on-call situation, and I'm not guaranteed students. I'm not guaranteed hours. I'm just opening myself up for a possibility. The job that I have right now is extremely fickle. So, yeah. Not very nice right now. I'm having to be available from not only 5 to 11 p.m. my time, but also 5 to 11 a.m. Meaning, I'm on call for basically 60 hours a week, but at the moment, I'm not even getting like 30 hours of pay a week. Not even 30 hours. So right now, with all of this going on, with my financial situation just being incredibly unpredictable in all the worst ways. I do have commissions and such open. I do have a coffee donation goal up top of 125. I understand that right now is a very, very chaotic time financially for a lot of us right now. So, like, if now is not a good time for you to donate or do anything for the streams, that is totally understandable. I more than understand, because I'm in a similar boat as well. I want to support folks, but I am not in the financial capability to do so. So, for those that...
Guess I'll have to compliment you even more.
Thank you, Zelda. I mean, you do it only if you want to. Whether it's the compliments, whether it's the donos, whether it's spreading word on Twitter to try and help get me a little more traction regarding my commissions and such. Any amount of support helps, even if it's emotional. Emotional support is probably just as important right now for myself and my fiancé Top Hat. Yeah. With that said, let's try and get back to our normal chill kind of spiel. And for those that do not know, one of my new VTuber friends is Venus Dawn MTK. Oh, was wondering what that was. But Venus Dawn MTK, for those that do not know her, give me just a sec, is a very, very awesome person. Absolute sweetheart. A half-demon culinary student, so loves to give a lot of facts regarding food, regarding cooking, like anything like that. While also being...
What's your commission sheet? I've got some spare change I can work with.
Yeah, so, Kaede, actually, if you're not in my Discord already, well, first off, for my Discord, you have to be 18 plus. I'm just saying that right now. But if you are 18 plus, and understand that my server is meant to be an LGBT, neurodivergent, and mental health safe space, you're more than welcome to join in. I recently put an Instagram post that has my Discord, that has my commission sheet. So if you got any questions related to that, you're more than welcome to DM me on there, or also consult me on Ko-fi. All right, but before we, I was meaning to try and say my little intro, but then I tangented onto the financial situation. But I am Road the Dusk. You can call me Road or Dusk or whatever you want to call a friend. I do variety streaming, so a lot of drawing, a lot of gaming, a lot of facts regarding mental health, dissociation, namely because I am AUDHD, so autistic and ADHD, as well as dissociative, more specifically OSDD or other specified dissociative disorder. So from personal experience, I can give a lot of facts related to mental health and neurodivergence. I do also love to give facts regarding ESL tutoring, linguistics, and things of that nature, because that is my repertoire. That is my current job. As little as it pays me right now, it is still my job, and it's still stuff that I enjoy. Like, language is one of my special interests. So, if any of that sounds interesting, feel free to stick around. I would very much appreciate the company. Alright. Let's go.
Can I call you amazing, adorable, and cute?
I mean, you can, but I'm not sure if that fits. I'm not sure if I actually fit that description. I hope everyone's been doing well today, by the way. If there's anything that's been going on or anything that you want clarification on, or you just want to say something for the sake of saying something and want to chat, feel free to. I always love to chat with you guys.
Bean.
Well, it takes a bean to know a bean. Thank you. I hope the lag isn't too bad, by the way. Or lag, delay. I keep muddling those words together.
I can't find it. Let me give you money.
Okay, weird. If you want Kaede, you can DM me, and in a bit I can send you, like, my commission sheet.
Take your time. I'm in no rush.
Yeah. Oh, actually, I just found it super quick. This is the wonders of ADHD. My brain immediately goes for the dopamine, so I'm like, you know what? I want to help this person. Like, they're wanting to do a thing. I want to help them do the thing, even though I'm working on something else. Boop. Okay. Alrighty.
Before I forget, here's a reminder that you're all amazing people, adorable beans, and a bunch of cuties.
It takes one to know one, Zelda. But thank you. I'm trying to figure out how to get the fingers properly interlaced. I hope everyone's been doing well, by the way. Like, my situation may be a little iffy right now, but, yeah. But I'm hoping that everyone else is having a good time.
The only downside is that I forgot to take meds 2 days in a row, but I'm taking them now.
Oh, that's a mood. that's a mood. At least you remembered today, like, getting back in the habit of taking your meds even after
always
one day.
Always having a good time when I'm with some of my favorite people.
Oh, thank you, Zelda. But yeah, no, Kaede, I get you with that. It can be really difficult to get back into the habit of taking your meds even after just one day of accidentally forgetting. Like, it's... ooh, that is a butt. Fingers crossed for you, mate. She always draws her nose so tiny. So I should probably make the nose tiny, because that's a little too thick of a nose. With some of the hair. We'll just have that color for now. Oh, so I heard that there's been a lot of hype for Dragon Prince Season 4, but also Vox Machina Season 2. Who else is excited for those?
Never heard of it before. Is it good?
The Dragon Prince? Oh, fuck yeah. It's created by the same guys that did Avatar.
I haven't seen Vox Season 1 yet. It's on my watch list.
I highly recommend it. As for Dragon Prince, I also highly recommend it. It's made by the same folks that did Avatar The Last Airbender and Avatar Legend of Korra. There's also some voice actors from the Avatar series that give some really great performances to some of the roles. There's really great LGBT representation and disabled representation, with the fact that one of the deuteragonists on Amaya is deaf. And she has a consort, that's not the right term, but there's someone on her team, on her platoon, that actually assigns for her and also is her voice when it comes to interacting with hearing folks. As for talking about Vox Machina, I also think that Vox Machina is really good. Coming from someone that marathoned the original campaign during the height of the pandemic, like, it's... Considering also the fact that the folks behind Critical Role are not only reprising their roles as the folks that they played in the Vox Machina campaign, but they also have a very, very close hand in making sure that the content is faithful while also, like, changing a few things for the sake of, like, also, like, obviously, like, stuff related for videos and such, but also retconning stuff in relation to Tiberius Stormwind, which I can totally understand. Yeah, it's honestly really, really good. Also, the voice actress behind Azula is Delilah Briarwood. Oh yeah, I gotta do her. Let's see, how does she... Oh yeah, they're just... You know, with how Venus draws her hair, like, it gives me massive, like, 90s, like, late 90s, early 2000s magical girl anime vibes, like Sailor Moon. Just with how like voluptuous and curvy and wavy the hair is. And I love it. I noticed that. If there's been any redeems for anything yet. Nope. Okay. Okay. Sorry, I got distracted from seeing something. Alright. Just gonna keep eye on the redeems. Are kind of on the drippy side, so her mascara is also pretty thick, so let's try and mimic that. She doesn't do anything for the bottom lash, so... Okay. Let's keep it at that. Sorry, getting distracted. Alright. Alrighty, daddy. Come on. Get the curve. There we go. Hold on just a moment, just remember to think. I'll worry about that later, but I'll have that prepared. I really like this music. I hope you guys like the music as well. I keep getting distracted.
It's coming.
Yeah. How quickly that reply came in, and seems like the lag is non-existent. Yeah, that looks better. That curve looks much better. need that to be on this layer. Okay. Now, yeah, because I like how the arms and such are, which I'm a little surprised with. So let's figure out a base eye color. There we go. That's looking better. Something's up with the bangs. Okay. Let's see if... altering the curve here will help at all. That's looking better. All right, now to bring this forward over this way. Get rid of that. Also, see, now something's off with the horn. Let's get that fixed. Huh? Wrong thing. There we go. For those that may be just hopping in, hi, hope you're doing well. I am Road to Dusk. You can call me Road, Dusk, anything that you would call a friend. I am a variety streamer that does a lot of drawing, gaming, as well as chatting about a lot of my special interests, and love to give facts related to not only my work as an ESL tutor, meaning I teach English as a second language, but also in relation to mental health and disability. I like to do a lot of fun stuff in relation to that. I love to collab with folks, but I also like to do some solo stuff. I namely just go where the wind takes me with a lot of stuff, especially when it comes to games, because I am very indecisive as of late. If any of that sounds like your cup of tea, please feel free to stick around. I'd appreciate the company. Please do know, though, that all of my streams are my streams and my Discord server are 18+. I know I look really cute. I look pretty say-so, but I'm not say-so. This is meant to be deceiving.
I'm 28. Do you still need to card me?
Nah, you're fine. You're fine, Kaede. Just as long as you're not doxing yourself.
I agree with you being a cutie.
Well, I mean, it takes one to know one, Zelda. Let's get the ridges on the horn. And let's actually get all of this in this so that I can get a glimpse of how this is flipped. I'm gonna have to warp it a bit later. All right. This is a really difficult pose. Why did I have to go for this pose? Oof. My back. My back does not like me right now. Just having a drink. So what's everyone been up to lately?
I'm playing Destiny 2 on my other monitor.
Oh, I've heard Destiny's pretty alright.
Still have your stream open though.
Nice. Yeah, I've heard Destiny is pretty alright, especially after some of the new patches. Oh wait, no, I'm mixing that with No Man's Sky. I know No Man's Sky had a lot of controversy when it first came out because it was very bare bones. But after some of the new patches, it's turned out to be a lot better. turn. Got a little bit of cravat. There we go. My back. I keep sitting in a really bad way. Little bells on the side ones here. So first, before we go too far, let's actually work on the body a bit more. Aren't quite aligning where I need them to. Before we get to the butt. I almost never draw people at this angle. So Venus, if you're watching the VOD of this, and I'm not doing you justice, I am so sorry. was that, actually? Ah, better than I expected. Okay. I'm still gonna need to... It'll be good to copy-paste this and have this as, like, a second thing so that when I get the back body done, I can move everything to where it needs to so that it looks better. Alright. This is... Yeah, that's that. I'll just have it as like a curve like that for now. I'll work on like the texture later. Now let's actually work on the texture for the for these for the leg covers. Oh, they flare out toward the bottom. Thank you. There we go, and there's that side. Oh, and I should do actually the... Okay, so yeah, they curve into the wrist. Pretty big, so since it is October, I don't know how many people here celebrate either casually, religiously, whatever, any of the holidays related to this month, but does anyone have any fun stories or events or anything that they're going to be doing during this time? I would say, like, for me, while I'm waiting for folks to respond, I'd say for me, I have some pretty decent memories. I remember the first time that I played, this isn't necessarily, like, Halloween related, but it is rather, like, it is related to, like, the scariness that is related to, or that can be related to, Halloween. I remember around the time of Halloween, I was playing a game that was a spiritual successor for the Fatal Frame series on the 3DS, and it was using AR, and it had this really neat book that would be used. Problem was that with a lot of AR stuff that the DS or the 3DS tried to achieve, it really struggled with its camera. And unless you had something that was like a really high quality image, which it had to be like a really good quality or good lighting, which most natural lighting could not achieve for the 3DS, it fumbled a lot. So I had to get like a PDF version of the book that I needed to play the game. When I did, it actually made the game like pretty immersive and really fun, engaging, and actually pretty intimidating, because for those that don't know the game that I'm talking about or the Fatal Frame series, you have to use a medium called the Oculus Obscura, and with the whole story of the Fatal Frame series, you have to use this Oculus Obscura to exorcise spirits and demons.
What was your question again? I wasn't paying attention.
No, you're good, Zelda. My question was, does anyone have any plans related to the coming holidays, or do you have any memories related to October holidays? Things like that.
I don't really have any plans for Halloween, unfortunately. After a while, celebrating the holiday kinda stopped being a thing with my family. Don't know why.
That's fair. It may be because a lot of people tend to see Halloween as like a children's thing, because costumes, parties and things like that nature. And while I can see that, at the same time, with knowing the history of Halloween, as well as like the inspirations of Halloween from pagan holidays such as Samhain and Irish folk traditions, like it's not as much of a kid's holiday or kid friendly then as it is now. And even then, there's like several aspects of Halloween that aren't.
I don't live with any family anymore, so I just drink apple cider and pass out candy in my Gudra Kigurumi.
I miss my Kigurumi. I used to have a Kigurumi of. I got it like years ago and it didn't fit me anymore, so I got rid of it. But it was the black and white bear from flipping Danganronpa. But if I were to get a Kigurumi again, I definitely want one of like a Meow Wow from Kingdom Hearts, because those things are fucking adorable. And also, Kigurumi make for super easy costumes. Like, no effort, all the comfort, especially during like a chilly night, like you're staying
Mine
warm.
Was custom made from a con friend.
Hey yo, I'm jealous, Kaede. I guess to kind of continue the conversation and continue kind of where that question leaves off, does anyone have any fun memories related to, like, Halloween or scary games or just situations like that? Could be not related to Halloween at all. It could just be something scary, but in like a fun way. Thank you.
I don't have any that comes to mind.
That's fair.
Box Off Sunshine, thank you so much for the follow.
Box of Sunshine,
I remember trick or treating as a kid and getting so much candy each year that I would fill up a pillowcase.
Oh, my sound alerts never went off. Sorry about that, there was supposed to be a cute little notification. I remember trick or treating as a kid and getting so much candy each year. Yeah, I actually remember there was one year when my siblings and I actually legit filled up a pillowcase. That all of that candy lasted a whole year. Like, mainly because just our family didn't allow us to eat it all in one go, which I don't blame them. That would have been really bad for our health. There we go. Now, before I go too far, actually, because we're getting close to done with line art, let's start making the
My parents never limited my siblings and I had no self-constraints. That candy lasted a few days.
Dang. Sorry, I'm like hyper-focusing on like the drawing right now because like my tablet, how I have it configured is like right down here. You can barely see my face, and I'm pretty sure this isn't tracking my mouth very well, but yeah. Just gotta work on the hooves, and then the line art should be basically done. I do want to go very simple with the line art for me, namely just because, hooey, just got a lot going on in the brain, and I'm not sure I got, like, I'm sure I can figure out a way to mimic the texture of, like, wool with how I'm going to do the coloring, but other than that, I don't think I can bring myself to go like too crazy with like texturing or like showing the texture and like extra crazy line art. Come on. Now for the fun part, to fuck around with this other part. Oh, actually, that might be the ticket. Alright, now to see how this looks flipped. That's not looking half bad. Definitely could be better. All right, now let's start getting the color swabs. Okay. A very peachy skin tone. It's very cute. Very nice. And her lip color. Color of the bow, highlight of the bow, and shadow. Right. For the fleece. Oh, and I still need to make the bells and the ribbons on the arm warmers. Crapola. Let's make the cuffs on. All right. Just give like a subtle nod to the ribbons on the back, even though you're really not going to be able to see them. You will, however, see them here. So. Oh, here's a blast from the past. Who remembers Halloween Town? Not Halloween Town isn't like Halloween Town from Kingdom Hearts, but Halloween Town is in like the Disney live action movie series.
I do. It was one of my favorites as a kid. I'm planning on watching it tomorrow with my little one.
Ooh, heck yeah. Yeah, because I just, like, remembered it as well, and I'm like, ooh, I haven't watched that in a while. Like, I'm probably going to be watching it either tonight after stream or, like, ideally sometime soon when I have time. Because I actually don't remember much of the movie, but I, like, remember how absorbed
Hocus
I was.
Hocus Pocus 2 is on Disney Plus.
Hocus Pocus 2 is on Disney Plus. I think that is only for those that, like, paid for, like, the special thing. Kind of like what they did with Mulan. And also, I'm really iffy to touch Hocus Pocus 2 now after learning that Betty, the woman that plays Winifred, is a TERF. Celine, I see you redeemed the second. Thank you. But yeah, no, I'm really iffy to watch Hocus Pocus 2, because, like, I was excited for Hocus Pocus 2, but then I heard that Betty, I forget her last name, but the woman that plays Winifred, who has been a pretty decent advocate.
I'm on mute right now, but hope it is going well, Mr. Comfy Artist.
Thank you, Celine. But yeah, we're just on a quick little topic slash tangent related to Hocus Pocus, because I asked, like, hey, who remembers Halloween Town? Someone said, hey, they remember Halloween Town, they're gonna watch it with their kid. Kaede said that Hocus Pocus 2 is coming out on Disney Plus, and that's where we're at currently. I'm really iffy about Hocus Pocus 2, because while Betty, the actress who plays Winifred Sanderson, has been a pretty decent advocate for the majority of the LGBT community, she has made it known that she is very turfy, and that makes me very disappointed. And I would rather not be supporting content that is made by, for, or with any phobic or supremacist kind of behavior, whether it's related to racism, gender, sexuality, whatever. That's also the reason why I don't support, I'm not gonna go into other people that I don't support, but let's just say she who shall not be named, a good part of people's childhoods. Let's switch subjects. Alright. Actually, going back to Halloween Town, what I wanted to say earlier was that I actually don't remember much of the story of Halloween Town. As much as I think that it is a really cool movie and show, I really don't remember a whole lot. The only things that I do remember was that I don't know if it was the first or the second movie where it was like, oh, it's a race against time to fix whatever, or else everyone in the real world is going to turn into monsters based on the costume that they have. And that sounded gnarly, but in a really cool way. I mean, think about it. Forget getting isekai'd. Getting isekai'd is boring. Just be corrupted into the thing that you want to be for one night, into the thing that you will be for eternity. Imagine the possibilities. If you dress up as Cthulhu, if you were other people dressed up as Cthulhu, or any folks of, like, various pantheons, imagine the freak out.
I want to be a gooey dragon Pokemon.
You know, speaking of Pokemon, especially considering Scarlet and Violet are still coming out in November, I'm kind of curious for shits and giggles, because what Pokemon would you guys see yourselves, and what Pokemon would you see myself as being? I am really not sure what kind of Pokemon I would be. First thing that's coming to my mind is honestly Eevee, because of the Eeveelutions and just how versatile Eevee is.
My favorite Pokemon is Zoroark, but I see myself as a Dragonite slash Gudra.
Ooh.
Chubby dragon pal.
Yeah, gotta love Gudra.
Give us an Amogus Pokemon.
An Amogus Pokemon? Huh? Excuse me. What do you mean by an Amogus Pokemon? Are you wanting like something that is suspicious? Are you wanting something that is kind of...
An imposter.
Dude, we got one! Fucking Mimikyu! Well, technically we got two. Ditto. Mimikyu and Ditto.
And Zoroark, kinda.
Zoroark, yeah, fair. I actually don't know a whole lot about Zoroark. Yeah, the main ones that I know and that I really love are Mimikyu and Ditto. Just use Oh, I should have gotten the color swap of her her eye color. Hold on. Something darker than that for, you know, I'll take this brownish kind of color for the eyes. I'll take this darker pink for... Take this darker pink for this. What can I do for her skin? I'll do that. That's what I wanted. Here we go. one she has is a very... So we'll desaturate it, lighten it a bit, desaturate it more. Bring a little more to the blue side. There we go. Oof. Let's just to double check that I'm going to get the colors right, not everything's cohesive. Alright, I think that will do it for the line art. Ow! Oh, my back really does not like me right now. Alright, so... let's get go- oh. I don't have her horns dark enough. Let's get that before I go too far. Oh, and her ears. Her ears need to be the same color as her fleece. Now that should be good. Alrighty. Now let's just add a few of the little finishing bits and add This is actually turning out to go a lot faster than I thought it would, but I think when I am finished with this, I will just finish for the night, because, yeah, I need to be prepared for the coming chaos that's going to be my work shift, which, for those that do not know, and or are just popping in to my stream, hi. I am Road to Dusk, you can call me Road, Dusk, anything that you would call a friend. Currently, I'm in a bit of a financial bit of a bind. My current work as an ESL tutor is not paying me nearly as much, or better phrasing, I am getting jack diddle for students at the moment, and that's really affecting how much money I'm getting, and by extension, what I can afford for helping my fiance and I with things such as making rent and paying bills. So I am trying to find a different job, but until that happens, I am currently actually having to work double shifts for my tutoring, meaning I am going to be working 12 hours a day, like 60-hour work weeks, for not really a whole lot of pay. And already, given the fact that my pay is fluctuating to hell and back, it's very chaotic and very, very, very sad right now. So while all this is going on and while I'm trying to look for a different job, I do have commissions and such open. I do have a donor goal up top for anyone that is curious. Yeah, all that is going on right now. And what you're seeing here is not a commission, this is a gift, and also meant to show a little bit of my skills and repertoire to you guys. If you feel comfortable and feel like you have the means to support me in any way, whether it is to have a subscription, whatever, to me on Twitch, or to commission me to do something, by all means, feel free to let me know. Now I'm trying to think of what I'm going to tackle first. Probably the skin. All right. Ow. where is it not joined? Hold on just a sec, guys. Sorry guys, Top Hat just came home and wanted to talk for a quick sec. Ah. That's one block. Now let's get let's just go section by section. Thank you. change the music real quick. Here we go.
Haven't said in anything in a while, so here's a reminder for Dusk that he's an amazing person, adorable bean, and a big cutie.
Thank you, Zelda. I'm actually a little surprised that my tone indicator message hasn't gone off at all throughout the stream. I'll have to mess around with my stream elements to make sure that it's actually working.
Just for that, here's a reminder for Dusk that he's an amazing person, adorable bean, and a big cutie /G/SRS.
Thank you, Zelda. I really appreciate it. Thank you. come on, where did I miss? Probably the lining right here. Yep, that was it. All right. I will say, if anyone has any like point redeems or anything that you guys want to use, like by all means, go for it. There's plenty, such as we have a little dragon here up top. His name is Terror. You can hang out with him. There's also Chef's Choice Trivia, which is basically I give a fact related to one of my special interests. There's also Dissociative Trivia. There's quite a few things that you can do. And when we play Cult of the Lamb, you can contribute to the cult's totem.
The art looks nice.
Yee! Thank you, Zelda. Care package. Thank you, Zelda.
I actually forgot to make myself
some snacks. I'll do that later.
And here's a full care package for the bean.
Thank you. I really appreciate it. I really hope that I can get a better job so I can save up money for a better goddamn chair. do the hair next for the blocking.
Here's a redeem for ya.
Chef's choice. Okay. So, for Chef's Choice trivia, I'm trying to think of a good one. Did you know that in the 1700s... hold on. Something's up on my internet. Something's looking weird on my end. Hold on, I'm gonna wait until I see that. I wanna wait till I get confirmation that everything is good internet-wise before I give the facts. So I don't wanna leave. I don't wanna leave people without what was redeemed. Someone say a thing in chat if you can still hear me.
E.
Okay, so the factoid this is going to be related to linguistics, more specifically English. Did you know that in the 1700s, during what is called the Enlightenment movement, there was and arguably still is a movement to try to Latinize the English language. This Latinization movement continues to today and is a direct cause of literacy rates in the United States and other English-speaking countries, and like illiteracy rates disparagingly affecting communities of color. The Latinization movement is a very direct example of how English has become a language of class, and the Latinization movement continues via capitalization of the English language, making it very difficult for immigrants, newcomers, and those with criminal records, and those of minority communities to better study and understand the language because of how much the English language now relies on Latinate terminology. Instead of the Germanic roots that we have, especially related to the language. Like, that's a big reason on why also, if you've had a teacher tell you in school, hey, don't end sentences in your essays with a preposition, that is from the Latinization movement. And it is kind of BS, considering at the, like, especially in casual English, which is more congruent to the English language Germanic roots, using prepositions at the end of sentences is extremely common. Yeah, there's your fact. There's your trivia.
Knowledge.
Yes.
spooky text-to-speech noises for Dusk's entertainment.
Thank you, Zelda. Oh, I actually do, your message reminded me of a thing, Zelda. So, I was recently informed, that there is a very racist history to the word spooky. And I'm trying not to use it as often as I used to, and I would very much love to have a conversation with folks regarding, is spooky still an okay term to use? Because while I completely understand and while I am unsure that people mean to use the term today in a xenophobic sense, I think it's still important to listen to people who are uncomfortable by the term. I want to have a conversation about this. Darn it. I like that color better. So I hope everyone's been doing well, by the way. I know I've talked with a few of you who've stuck around in chat. I would love to hear what's going on with everyone so far. It is like 10:40 for me. I normally keep going until midnight-ish. I probably won't be going until that late tonight, namely because I got stuff going on tomorrow, such as another stream, namely a collaboration with Tiny Foxtrot, Monkey Mallow, Asterisk Official, and quite a few others where we are going to fuck around and play some Gardic Phone. So tomorrow is going to be a whole lot weirder and a whole lot more chaotic compared to tonight. Yeah, tonight is all nice and cozy, but tomorrow the gloves are going to be off. So be prepared for that.
Not much going on here. May have hopped on a game earlier and played a few matches, but
Ooh.
Now I'm here and vibing.
Yeah, fair. What game was it? You know, speaking of gaming and current events and such, I guess, what are everyone's thoughts related to the chaos with Overwatch 2?
Played some World of Warships Legends first to do my daily challenges, and then hopped on Fortnite to level up a few times.
I see. I keep contemplating getting into Fortnite, but I'm not sure I would do very well. Also, it sounds like people don't want to talk about, like, I'm just saying this as a statement, an observation. It seems like people don't want to be talking about Overwatch, which is totally fine. So, what would y'all like to talk about? Alright.
I don't have any topics of note. I'm down to hear you talk about whatever, though.
One thing that I've been wanting to do, and I'm not sure if I still want to do it because of all the schedule stuff and work, is that I originally wanted to start doing a community movie night on my Discord server. And I've been really wanting to get people to watch, especially one of my favorite musicals, The Guy Who Didn't Like Musicals. For craps and giggles, I might do it either tonight or tomorrow, just because I want to be able to do it before everything regarding like my sleep schedule and such has to be changed due to work stuff. Does that sound of interest to anyone? And if so, I will put a link to my Discord server.
I've been asked to help make something real quick.
Ooh.
I'll be back soon.
Okie dokie. Yeah, have a good one, Zelda. Be safe. Oof. Oh, I just got a nice pop all of a sudden. To figure out the best spots for why can't I that would be why.
I'm back with mac and cheese.
Ooh, mac and cheese. Nice. Did you put anything in the mac and cheese? Did you do like hot dogs or ham or anything like that? Or is it just plain mac and cheese?
Plain. Don't have anything to put in it, unfortunately.
Aww. That's fair. Well, what I would recommend next time is if you have salt and pepper, cook it like you would like pasta. Put some salt in the water before it boils, and it'll help to add some extra flavor to the noodles. Then again, that is if you really like salt, because I know like a lot of mac and cheese kits are already pretty salty, so make it that what you will.
So, did y'all know that you and everyone else in chat are a bunch of cuties?
Oh, it takes one to know one, Zelda.
Not. I just know a cutie when I see one.
Well, then you need to look in the mirror more often.
Out of curiosity and to spark a bit of conversation, is there a game you've played with lore that fascinates you?
Well, I mean, definitely Cult of the Lamb. Cult of the Lamb has some really interesting lore, in my opinion. Outside of that, really, the vast majority of games that I play have lore. Like, it's very rare that I will ever play a game that doesn't have lore, such as rhythm games, like Taekwondo Tatsujin or Project D.Va. But when it comes to, like, games outside of that, like, I very much prefer lore. Like, honestly, obviously, like, Kingdom Hearts, like, I go hog wild over Kingdom Hearts anytime that I get the chance. Also, the Persona and Shin Megami Tensei series. What about you, though, Zelda? Have there been any that have caught your attention?
Based on the lore from the games themselves, I definitely like the lore of the Fallout series. When it comes down to lore expanded upon in books, comics, and the like, Halo is up there, even though I'm not knowledgeable in everything about the series.
I actually haven't heard a whole lot about the lore of Halo. So I'm really curious to hear a bit about that, not gonna lie.
I also enjoy the lore of my favorite video game, which has a few books and comics to make the universe a bit bigger.
Ooh.
Though I suppose it is definitely odd in an interesting way.
Odd in an interesting way, what do you mean by that? Look at who all is streaming right now. Ooh. Because I am getting close to done with this. I'm actually surprised at how quick this is going. Depending on who all is going to be playing by the time that I finish up, I have an idea on who we're going to be raiding, unless someone has enough points to redeem the Pass the Baton, which will mean that you get to pick who we're going to be raiding out.
Well, the first game to be released had aliens, conspiracies, and things like that, while the prequel game made it seem like there was something mystical in the universe with something that could supposedly make people into gods or supposedly godlike beings.
Well, that's interesting. That is really, really neat.
Also, sorry for the late response. Sometimes I'm fast at typing things on mobile, while other times I'm as slow as a tortoise.
Hey, stuff happens. All good. Are you There we go.
Interestingly enough, I've recently finished reading the books that serve as prequels to my favorite video game, so I have a somewhat decent knowledge on the events of the series. First time I can say that about any franchise I like.
I mean, that's pretty cool though. What are some of your favorite parts of the lore related to that series?
Finally got my capture card in and working, so like, now I can finally stream Bloodborne.
Yo, that's awesome. And Bloodborne? Dang, I haven't heard about that in a good while.
It's my Halloween spooky game every year, but now I can stream it.
Nice.
The part that interests me the most is the conflict between global corporations. In the series, these hyper-corporations are very powerful and influential, so whenever they take matters into their own hands to suit their interests, things get interesting.
Oh, okay. I mean, it doesn't sound too dissimilar to how things are now, but interesting. Bottom color is the lips. Thank you.
If you'd like, I can try coming up with a short rundown on the story of the my favorite game and its prequels in DMS so that I don't clutter up the chat.
Ooh, that'd be fun actually. I'd appreciate that. Alright, now to work on a background. After I merge all these together. Here we go. Ah! Alrighty. Not the Gaussian yet. Is it Gaussian or Gaussian? However you pronounce that. Oh, that's too thick. That's too thick for lining. Let's redo that. Instead of 5%, let's do 3%. That's perfect. Alright. And normally for... Let's add like some... Let's add some of this. Thank you. just one more vertical and horizontal pass. And then that should be a perfect circle.
Interestingly enough, I made an account on a world-building forum so I can give my own backstory to some of the aliens I mentioned Ooh. Earlier from the franchise. Since there's not really much that is known about them in the series, I thought it'd be cool to come up with my own stuff.
That does sound pretty cool. I'm really curious to know some of the lore that you've made up.
Damn boy, she thissy.
I know she thick. Venus told me that she's supposed to be thick, so I made her thick.
Thissy.
See, I love how flippin' TTS can't say thick with the two C's. Alright. Well, let's add a little bit of extra flair for the background, actually, because see. Maybe add like a solar flare or something related to light.
Since it would probably be easier, I can send a link to the part of the forum where I posted the lore on the species themselves.
Ooh.
It might be easy to navigate to the rest of the stuff from there and read in your free time.
Yeah, that would actually be really cool. I'd appreciate that. I think I want to fudge around with the background a little bit more before I officially like put this on any of my socials. But this is... I'm really happy with how this turned out. And it looks like who I was wanting to stream is still streaming. Who I wanted to raid is still streaming. That's what I want to say. So we are going to be streaming out, unless someone wants to redeem Pass the Baton, we are going to be streaming out my stream mom, Rinka Mew, who's also one of my mods, but obviously since she is streaming right now, she's not able to mod, which is totally fine. For those that do not know her, hold on, let me give her a shout out super quick so you can see her stuff. Recently, actually, she had a re-debut, given, like, just a whole bunch of hype and such. Like, it was really, really awesome. She had a few technical difficulties, but everything was able to get fixed up by the time that she had everything, set up. So, yeah. We are going to raid out my, hold on. Well, before we do that, let's get the...
The road to dusk has led the raiders to you.
Let's get the Hello. Messages for like the raid messages and such going. So that's gonna be the normal. And hold on, let me set up the raid one super quick because Stream Elements doesn't like my little command for my subscriber. One.
The road to dusk has led the raiders to you.
So there we Hello. Go. And let's get ready for that raid. So before I set things up, I do want to give everyone a massive thank you for those that stuck around and saw the stream today. Thank you so much for the company and conversation. Thanks so much for like offering to help with anything, especially when it comes to the financial situation that I'm dealing with. Hopefully, tomorrow will be another very fun day. I'm gonna have another stream going on with Asterisk Official, Monkey Ballow, Tiny Foxtrot, and quite a few more people that are trying to get in, that are either veterans or newbies to the VTubing scene. With that said, let's get that raid officially going.
Leaving made chat reset for me. Can you post the raid message for followers again?
Sure. Let me get this.
The road to dusk has led the raiders to you. Hello.
There you go, Zelda. But for everyone that has stuck around, thanks so much for the support. Please be sure to give Rinka some support as well, as we're going to get ready for her. She is playing The Darkness 2. I actually don't know that game. Be warned, it is very gory from what I hear. So trigger warning for like blood, gore, viscera, things like that. It is a horror game. If that's not your cup of tea, you are more than open to back out. I'm sure me and Rinka will understand. But before I tangent too much, thank you all so much. Have a wonderful rest of your morning, afternoon, evening, whatever time it may be in your time zone. And know that the road to dusk is always open for another adventure. Thanks so much, and I'll see you again sometime soon. Bye! Oh God, oh God, oh God, oh God, oh God.